A bit more detail now, we're stood on the seawall. We've got the Essex Estuary's special area of conservation. This is the Blackwater Estuary here. It's been designated for its salt marsh and mudflat features, predominantly, but also as a supporting area for birds. On this side of the wall, we've got the Altal Marsh's special protection area, designated mainly for bird populations. With the onset of sea level rise and increased storminess, we're starting to see more and more erosion of the salt marshes and mudflats out here. If you look out at these raised banks, that's actually eroding salt marsh. That would have been stands of salt marsh that are now being eroded down. But sooner or later, this seawall will become, from an engineering perspective, unviable, because of course, as you lose that salt marsh and mudflat, the seawall becomes exposed to more and more wave energy.
We've gone out into the field and we've seen the sites, we can put it in perspective and understand them and almost sort of grasp what's going on. And I think that's been the best part of it, is these trips, and seeing it happening and seeing what it's like.
You're actually in the field, that you get more of a connection with what you're studying rather than just learning about it and reading about it.
This is actually one of the cases where they say, well, strategically, what we've got to do is recreate this habitat further inland. Once we're satisfied that that habitat is the ecological equivalent as far as the birds are concerned, we will then take sections of this seawall out on a carefully engineered and modelled basis. So the question that I'd leave you with to think about as we walk along the seawall here is, what do you do? Do you just wait for nature to take its course, nature albeit nature that's been driven by sea level rise and increased storminess, climate change, and eventually inundate the site, in which case we just lose the freshwater grazing marsh? Or do you strategically go in there and purposefully take sections of this seawall out and flood this area, but only once you have recreated it further inland?
When you look at how much, I suppose, we've probably reduced biodiversity, it's actually we're responsible for its loss, essentially. So perhaps we should be the ones who are doing something about it.
And as I think I've explained before, do nothing, losing this site as a result of an accidental breach of the wall is arguably the worst of all options.
The aesthetic beauty that comes with being outside and in the field and appreciating it, like on a day like this and the walk we've done, that to me is what it's about, and it's sort of part of saving that for future generations.